5 million homes in Britain are provided at reduced rent through social housing.
You get over 1,200 clients bidding for the one property.
But with 4.5 million people in the queue, there's a long wait.
I've been on a Tower Hamlets waiting list somewhere near 10 years now.
Now it's 9 years now, still waiting.
Probably about 300 or 400 bids for it.
Keep bidding as you're doing.
When a vacancy does come up, competition is fierce.
It's not as if I'm being choosy. I can't even get a look in.
Is the bailiff here?
I'm going to be evicted.
Would you be keen on taking this property?
I'd be happy to live here.
It's down to local councils to decide who deserves a home the most.
We don't have a vast amount of properties come available. That's the difference between us and an estate agent.
We've got a conflict of interest here. We can't help you.
As each household stakes a claim for the keys to a council house.
We've got a 3-month-old baby. I feel that gives us a bit of a priority.
I would love to have that place.
I would really prefer just something with a garden.
The London borough of Tower Hamlets is at capacity. The council is dealing with the fastest growing population in the United Kingdom. It's also one of the country's poorest areas. There's a queue of over 20,000 households trying to get a council house.
Why there are no council flat, right, for us? And I would like to know what is the next step.
We will never be able to match demand with supply.
Yeah, but she's heavily pregnant as well.
It's a struggle that requires more and more resources, more and more innovation, more and more energy. How long we can continue to do that, I don't know.
With just 30 properties a week becoming available, a bottleneck has formed. Some of the few properties soon to become available include this one-bedroom flat. A rarity as it's situated on the ground floor. And this fourth floor flat, currently undergoing a full refurbishment. But who deserves the keys the most?
Steven, put 17, please. Interview room number 17, please. Good morning to you.
Who are you, sir?
How are you?
In a lot of pain.
Oh, good, good. What's your date of birth, please?
19th of the 10th. 78, not 60. I've got to keep me human, mate, you know what I mean?
For 53-year-old Steve, Tower Hamlets has been his manor his whole life.
I mean, all my family was born in the East End, even not just my grandparents, like my grandparents' brothers and sisters, you know, so, and anyone with their surname is family.
Steve is hoping for a ground floor council property. He currently lives in a one-bed apartment, but as he suffers from arthritis, the 40 stairs have become unbearable.
My life has changed so dramatically, and my prospects are just none. My current condition means I'm unemployable. And on a bad day, I don't like to say this, but on a bad day, I'll cry. It makes me depressed. And it really gets me upset. And I feel like I'm in a fucking jail cell. You know, I feel like I'm in prison, in a luxury prison, if you like.
To make matters worse, the landlord of his private rented flat wants his property back.
Unfortunately, I've just had a notice to quit. So I've got to be out by February the 28th, which has, you know, really set my life into chaos. I'll have bailiffs coming round. And I'll have the right to probably kick the door in or enter the property and just clear out my stuff. You know what I mean? You just feel hopeless. No hope. What's really in the world?
With his eviction looming, Steve has just 6 weeks to find a new home.
So basically, you want a proper council.
I would like a tenancy.
Yes. Yeah. We have to be realistic. Yeah, there are lots of people on the waiting list, and the chances are very small.
Have they all lived in this borough all their life?
I should think so.
With so many people on the waiting list, Steve needs to convince the council his housing application is more urgent than others.
Are you disabled?
Well, I've got arthritis.
Arthritis?
I'm in constant pain. I just cannot deal with stairs. I'm also a recovering alcoholic. You know, I mean, I've relapsed a few times, but at the moment I'm doing my best to not drink. I haven't got no asbos, so I'm not a danger to none of my neighbours. All my neighbours love me.
That's very good, yeah.
Even the ones that can't speak English.
Hmm. So if you want a council property, you have to continue to bid. So I cannot say to you that you will not get a council flat. No. However, my job here is to advise you to consider other options. We may be able to help you get you accommodation in private sector.
It's possible that you will get a council accommodation, but the likelihood that very soon that's going to happen, that cannot be guaranteed.
I'd rather it be a tenancy, something in my name, and a tenant of the council. The private sector, you've got no security, you don't know where you stand.
I've been a resident in this borough all my life. Yes, I think I should get priority.
Getting your hands on a council house isn't easy with such a shortage of housing stock. So the council have devised a bidding process where applicants can stake a claim on newly available properties.
Tower of Ambulance operates a choice-based letting system, and this allows applicants to note their interest in the type of accommodation that we have available each week. Now it's down to the client to choose if they wish to be considered for that particular property by placing a bid.
It's a two-bedroom, a nice size.
Third floor, one lift, which is good.
Yeah, that would be a nice property to bid on.
When the applicant places a bid, the computer works out their bid position based on how long they've been waiting and their level of need or priority.
There is quite a few people in front of me, which is about 160 people at the moment.
Well, this is 255 above me.
It's just like a waiting game, really.
Bidding closes every Friday, and the system analyses which applicants are at the top of the list for each property. But even then, the ordeal isn't over. This one-bedroom council flat in Tower Hamlets has just become available. The property's been fully refurbished. Privately, it would fetch in the region of £265 a week. But the council are offering it at a more affordable £104 a week.
We've got a viewing of a one-bedroom flat on the fourth floor. There's three applicants that's going to be viewing the property.
Local resident Dean is currently unemployed and has come to the viewing with his father.
I'm here because I've been on a Tower Hamlets waiting list, and I've been on it roughly, I don't know, somewhere near 10 years now. And this is actually my first viewing for a flat in the 10 years that I've been on.
It's lovely, one bedroom. They're on a general waiting list applicants, all three of them. And they're all single. They all bid for this place.
Live with parents at the moment, and I feel like I've got to that age where I just need to sort of get out. Independence, you know?
How old are you?
I'm 30, 31 in May. I feel I'm way over the limit to actually be still living with my parents.
Applicant number one, they're first on the list for refusal. If for any reason they refuse, the offer is made to applicant number two. And if they accept, great. If they don't, then it goes to applicant number three.
I'm actually third on the list. As far as I know, there's up to about six of us going to be viewing, and I'm the third choice, third person. If the other two obviously turn it down, then it's down to me.
I was hoping I'd be probably the only one here. Yeah, no way. Yeah.
This one-bedroom council flat has just become available. Local resident Dean has been on the council's waiting list for 10 years, and this is his first viewing.
Maybe I deserve a place for living here so long, but there's people out there that have worse problems than what I do.
Applicant number one, have a look at the property first, and then number two, and then we'll call you in.
But as he's applicant number three, Dean will only be offered the property if the two people in front of him turn it down.
What can you do? Private renting is going through the roof. There's not really much you can do. If you've got to wait, you've got to wait. We're British, and we were used to standing in queues.
The brand new kitchen and brand new bathrooms. What do you think? Do you like it?
Yeah.
Not sure.
It's a nice area.
Yeah, it's a good size. It's a double bed. So do you want to think about it?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll let applicant number two in then. Applicant number two. Okay, so everything's been replaced.
Yeah, I could see myself living here. But I say it's a nice area. There's nothing wrong with it. The walls ain't falling down around me or nothing.
Do you like it? Okay. We're just going to let applicant number three in now. Mr. Dean Febb, you want to come in? Come in. New bathroom and kitchen. Just over a year and a half ago. This is with the living room. We've got a private balcony at the back. This with the bedroom. What do you think?
Yeah, I'd say it's decent size. Better than what I'm in the room I'm in at the moment.
If, for example, applicant number one and two refuses a property, would you be keen on taking this property?
Yeah, I don't see why not. I'd be happy to live here.
Okay, we're just gonna go out and see if number one have made a decision. We're done, sorry. Okay, applicant number one, have you decided? You're gonna accept the property? Okay. Sorry guys, applicant number one accepted the property. Yeah? Two and three, sorry. You'll be number one, hopefully, soon. Now you're on the top of the list, so you're just gonna have to carry on bidding.
I am a little bit disappointed, but like I say, because I was free, it's just one of them things. Hopefully next time I'll be closer to the top. Hopefully it won't take me another 10 years to actually get into another place.
Dean's wait to fly the family nest isn't over yet. As families expand, the council is left to deal with an increasing problem.
Families are given accommodation that meets the needs at the time of the allocation. And we have never, ever been in the comfortable position where we've been able to allocate accommodation that anticipates that families will grow. And of course, families will grow.
When Rahula and her husband moved into this two-bedroom maisonette, they only had one child.
When I got married, I always wanted a little bit bigger family.
Now the couple have six daughters and are desperate for a larger home.
Now it's 9 years now. Still waiting.
I sleep on the bottom of the bunk with my younger sister. At the top, my second older sister sits there. My older sister, who's 19, she sleeps on the single bed. In the other room, my mum sleeps with my baby sister and my younger sister. The whole house is getting damp, really, in the corners. I think it's because we've been living here for such a long time.
It's really difficult, especially for this country, to suffer with my children like that.
4 3-bedroom or two-bedroom property, you could get over 1,200 clients bidding for the one property.
We just can't help everybody. It's unfortunate. It's not a quick fix here.
The strain of these overcrowded conditions often becomes too much to bear, and family members are forced to leave. With a limited supply of council property available, the housing office is having to go to extreme lengths to house those most in need.
Families will present to us, often in an emergency situation, and we respond in that emergency by providing bed and breakfast accommodation.
So, just changing the baby.
Unemployed 26-year-old Sharif and his young family have been given one room after being evicted from his family home.
You can see that it's not really spacious enough for a family of three. So it is a bit difficult, but we get on, we push through. And my mum lives in a two-bedroom house, and there was me, my mum, two of my sisters and my partner. So it was really, really overcrowded. So we had to, when baby arrived, we stayed there for a few weeks, but there wasn't enough space. So we had to move. Like, my mum said that we had to leave. It's difficult. It's stressing me out a little because I have to hold myself together for my baby and for my partner.
It's not fair. If it was just a pair of us, it would be fine. We could cope with it. But she's the one who's, you know, little and she doesn't realise. So.
What would you like for the future?
A home. Somewhere, you know, somewhere safe and stable, somewhere she could wake up and think, you know, am I going to get a phone call today and are we going to have to move? You know, has she got a place to, you know, play and just have fun? She can't do that. She can't grow and learn, and it's just not fair.
We've got a 3-month-old baby, and a baby is supposed to be, they're supposed to be brought up in a stable home, comfortable. So that, I feel that gives us a bit of a priority.
By law, the council can only house families in bed and breakfasts for up to 6 weeks.
Families will spend a short period in bed and breakfast, and then their journey will be to self-contained temporary accommodation, typically a council property, now owned by a private landlord, and is now renting back to us what was social housing stock originally. We are paying an awful lot more rent than the original rent for that property. That's a fact of life.
In Tower Hamlets, it costs £31 million a year to house families in temporary accommodation. With such a long waiting list for a permanent place, families can be housed like this for years and often become attached to their homes. Marilyn and her two children have been in temporary accommodation for 10 years.
Lily, you're following me.
Having fled their original home due to domestic violence.
Well, I used to live in a house. It was brand new. I lived there for 8 years. But I had to move out because of domestic violence. And the social services, I have to go for my safety. But I didn't really want to leave this house because I love the house. Oh. Says, don't worry, you will get another place. You'll get another house. So I thought, okay, let me take that chance. So I took that chance.
It costs £323 a week to house the family in this 2-bedroom flat. But the council has now told them they must leave.
You know, tomorrow I'm going to be evicted. I haven't got nowhere to go yet, and they're supposed to come at 8 o'clock in the morning. Yeah? I'm not going nowhere. I'm staying put. Because I haven't got a roof on my head. I got all my furnitures in the flat, and I haven't got nowhere to go.
After 9 years of unsuccessfully bidding for a permanent property, the housing office offered Marilyn 3 different council homes, but she turned them all down.
But you can't just turn around and give me what I never bid for. That's not fair. I went to look at it, and then the man in the builder that was decorating the place there, because it's a nice place, isn't it? I goes, is it? I said, not for me, mate. And I looked around, I says, no, thank you. And I walked away.
The council has decided it can no longer justify the expense of keeping Marilyn in temporary accommodation.
We've got into this very unfortunate situation because Marilyn has been bidding for many, many years for properties that she will not get. I think the problem is that she didn't understand the difference between exercising choice and choosing what she wanted and what she was actually going to be able to get, because I think she... I'm assuming she just thought that she could get what we couldn't give her.
I don't want too much, but at least you could have given me something better than that. You give the people what they want. The reason why they give me this place there, because nobody wants it.
For the last decade, the council has been storing Marilyn's furniture free of charge. But 2 months ago, her possessions were returned to her.
This is my sitting room, which I've got all my furniture here because it was in storage for 10 years and I cannot move. And that's the way I'm living. And it's a nightmare. Could come in here now. This is my bedroom. That's where me and my daughter sleeps. And it's just crowded. Not even a cat can swing in there. So I'm living like a pilcher.
Marilyn has had 6 weeks' notice of her eviction, but now has just 24 hours to vacate the property.
People that are born in this country, they can't get a place. And people come over here, they're the ones that's getting the first priority to get a place. The system is not fair.
Steve is hoping for a council flat, but time is not on his side. He's facing eviction from his privately rented home in just 2 weeks.
I want a tenancy. I want a tenancy. I want a place that I can call my home. Ground floor, senior type, fixed term. I would love to have that place. Total weekly cost, £171.27. That's £80 cheaper than here. Now that is a result. Right, I'm gonna go apply now, right? There are. At present, there are 234 people in front of me.
Because there's such a shortage of social housing, the council is encouraging people further down the waiting list to move into private accommodation.
So I want to call all these offices and see how I get on.
They've offered to help pay the deposit if Steve can secure a privately rented flat for no more than his £245 a week housing benefit.
Hello, how can I help?
Yeah, I was just wondering if you've got any one-bedroom or studio apartments to let on the ground floor.
We've got one bed on at £300 per week, just off Hackney Road.
Right, well, my budget will be £250 a week. You say it's ground floor, yeah?
Yeah, it's ground floor.
Do you accept housing benefit with good references?
Unfortunately, we just don't really.
Do you take housing benefit?
I don't believe we do down here, no.
Thank you.
About that.
That's fine, darling, thank you. I don't want private housing. I'm in a little bit of pain. I was a recovering alcoholic. I must be insane to start drinking because of what it does to me. I'm smoking things 20 times worse.
What might do that?
The stress. 245 quid a week.
I don't have any one bed for
£245
a week.
That one's a no, that one's a no. I've got references from my previous landlord. Please, my friend, if you can find me something, you would really make my day.
345 they want for a
345 for a one bedroom.
If he doesn't find somewhere to live in the next fortnight, Steve could be made homeless.
I ain't really getting nowhere very fast.
Mm-hmm. In Tower Hamlets, there are 20,000 households waiting for a council property. But each week, only 30 homes become available, with larger family houses the most rare. Retired bus driver Jill has been in her council house for 20 years. She lives alone in a three-bedroom maisonette.
This is my home. When I first moved in here, I had all my children with me, so it was a family home. I'm hoping to downsize, but at the moment, I'm getting nowhere fast.
On the private market, Jill's property would cost around £330 a week to rent. But the council charges just £127.
It's nice. It's a nice place, you know. I can't understand why they haven't pulled my arm off to get it for somebody. A big family. I'm just rumbling around here all on my own. This is another spare room. People could be living here. Stupid. Absolutely stupid.
The council wants her property to ease their long list of waiting families. So she's been placed at the top of the priority list. But they can't force Jill out, and she hasn't found anywhere to tempt her to move.
Tower Hamlets has quite a few applicants that are living in properties that are larger than what they require. Single people living in 3- and 4-bedroom accommodation. But there's no policy to say that if you're in larger accommodation, you must give up the property.
I just think I really deserve, I mean, that's the wrong word to use, but I would really prefer to have a house than anything else, or just something with a garden. If you want to live in a tower block, there's plenty of them, but it's just nothing suitable. And I feel that if I can't get what I want, then I'm not moving. Simple as that.
The council is having to rent expensive private properties until permanent council houses can be found for its 2,000 homeless households. Having refused 3 permanent offers, Marilyn is now about to be evicted from her temporary accommodation. But desperate not to lose her home, she's preparing for a siege.
Get up early in the morning before they come and get me. I bought me chicken. A whole chicken that would last me at least 2 days. That would do. I will survive. I've got my Swiss roll. I've got everything. My crackers. I like my crackers with my cheese. When they come, I'm not going to open my door. I'm staying put. So I need food for me to eat. Simple.
If we have a situation where people are just refusing to move out of temporary accommodation, we have to use our powers and get them moving so we can free up the properties for those people who are coming behind them.
At 10 a.m, the bailiffs arrived to start the eviction.
I've got butterflies now. What can I say?
Is the bailiff on the call here? If you open the door, we'll go to speak to you and tell you and advise you what you can do.
Marilyn, they will force entry. You don't want them to force entry, do you?
And you've got the amount of time it takes for the police to get here.
My kids aren't supposed to go through that. Do you understand me? Not at all. And that's not fair.
Once the police are here, we're going to come in. If you don't open the door, we're going to force entry.
Look what he's got. He's got his crowbar.
Listen to me. The police are here.
So what are you trying to say? So when you come in, then what happens to us?
Marilyn, it's the police. Can you let me in to discuss this, please?
I haven't done anything. I haven't done no crime. If I come out of this house, I'm on the street.
Either way, you let me in and we have a quick discussion, or we'll just force entry, so it's up to you.
After an hour, the door is forced open.
Yeah, go ahead. Thank you. That's the police, yeah? Want to chat with you?
But they've been very spiteful for me. No understanding. Don't lie for you, lot. You've got a roof on your head, innit? I'm packing some clothes for my son. I'm packing some clothes for myself. and my daughter's packing her clothes.
Are you ready, honey bunch?
All right then, come on. Unfair because they should have given me something long time ago, 4 years ago, back in 10 years ago. Plus, this is criminal, I'm not criminal.
People sadly have to understand that we can only do so much. We can't have a situation where we're effectively bed blocking temporary accommodation. I've got families sitting in bed and breakfast hotels for far longer than they should do because I don't have enough temporary accommodation to move people into.
The council is faced with such a shortage of available properties that a quarter of those in temporary accommodation have to be housed outside the borough.
You're going to Swanscombe, Dartford. The nearest affordable one we have for yourself is Kent.
Kent, that's the problem.
Yeah, Kent.
For my support, like midwife and everything, they're all here.
Yeah, I mean, this is only temporary. You moved out there till you can get yourself a permanent accommodation, so you can get that back in the borough.
If it's just temporary, I don't really want to transfer anything.
Yeah, but I mean, it's temporary as in at least maybe 1, 2, 3 years. It's a big adjustment. You're moving out of the area you've been in, but as the cheapest accommodation, unfortunately, is moving further and further out.
New parents, Sharif and Laura, have only just joined the waiting list for a council house. Because they have a baby, they were given emergency accommodation and placed in a bed and breakfast room.
Well, I got a phone call yesterday about 5 o'clock, 5:30. I had a phone call from housing lady telling me that she's got a temporary flat for us in Enfield. And then when I heard temporary flat, I was overexcited. I didn't hear it. What else? She said so much other stuff to me, but I didn't pay attention. I just heard, yeah, we have your flat, come 9:30 in the morning for your keys.
It's took forever to get here. Definitely, it took forever. But good things come to those who wait.
Sheriff, to booth one, please.
While they wait for a council house, they've been allocated temporary accommodation, but it's in a different borough.
We've got your property. This is the address where it is. Here.
Yeah.
Is it one or two bed?
It's a one bedroom.
Do you know if it's on the ground floor?
I'm not too sure.
Okay. Yeah. It's a surprise then.
Our first home together. Gonna be excited. I don't know where we are anymore.
Yeah, it's like walking into the unknown really. Well, it says it's half an hour on the train, so it is quite scary, so especially with a child.
If sold, this one-bedroom ground floor flat would cost around £150,000.
I think it's this one. It's our sweet new home.
A lot.
Cupboards.
Everything's here?
I'm so excited.
I mean, I'm already imagining where the sterilizer's gonna go and.
What, a shower?
Electric.
Oh, wow. Yes.
Let's have a look at the bedroom. The boudoir. You can put the bed here, the cot here. Oh, I like the sofa.
In B&B, we just had one room and a little sink. And a fridge. Here we've got everything.
How much does this place cost a week?
I don't have a clue. Yeah, don't know.
£320 a week.
Ooh.
We're definitely blessed to have a ground floor like this. Definitely. And we deserve it. We really deserve this. Because we waited bloody well long enough.
That's our home for the next few years, hopefully.
I'm thinking forever, like the way I'm planning everything.
Steve is also having to look at properties outside Tower Hamlets. With little chance of getting a council house before he's evicted from his private flat, he's come to view a property that will accept tenants on housing benefit.
Well, I must be honest, it's on the ground floor. A bit small, but what can I expect? Just let me check the kitchen out. Don't like the ob, mind you. And the oven's a Zanussi instead of a Bosch. Thank God it hasn't got 40 steps to get there.
The council has agreed to pay his deposit if they're satisfied he can afford the rent.
Yeah, the bedroom's very adequate. It's a lovely place and I'd love to have it.
Although this ground floor flat is cheaper than it would be in Tower Hamlets, it's still £50 a week more than Steve's housing benefit, which goes against council policy.
The market value for rental and what they as a benefit pay is means I don't actually, there ain't nothing I can find within that cap. It's as simple as that.
Steve's fate is now in the council's hands.
How are you?
In a lot of pain, darling, to be honest. A really bad pain.
I have spoken to my manager.
Yes, he has a problem with the shortfall.
My family and friends are ready to rally up for me the £50 shortfall or just slightly less. I've lived in this borough for 53 years, sweetheart, and I found a property that's very adequate.
When we put somebody in a tenancy, the whole point of us paying out the money is so that they can get into a property where they can sustain it.
Well, I can sustain it, so what's the problem?
But then we have to be sure that you can do that.
Well, I'm telling you I can.
Concerns around that.
So where am I meant to live? I can't deal with this anxiety. I can't deal with it. The stress is driving me... Sorry, I nearly swore, but please. Have you got any plans for me or any suggestion?
What you need to do is look for a different property. This property is unaffordable. You can't afford the amount that the
fucking... I feel like throwing a fucking phone. What you're saying is now then it's a no, is that what you're saying? Have you got a suitable property lined up for me then? You know, what is a suitable property?
I do not have a suitable property.
I can only deal with a ground floor. Have I got to let the landlord take me to court? And then if the bailiff train slinging me on the streets, next I'll be homeless. What is wrong with your manager?
If you find a property...
It's within local housing allowance, we are willing to pay £664.30, which is the local housing allowance for one bedroom in Epping Forest.
Darling, get in the real world. Go out there and try to find a place to live in Tower Hamlets. Go anywhere in London. I'm sorry I'm shouting, but I ain't going nowhere. I ain't going forward nowhere, and it's making me really ill.
Before we continue with anything else...
Just get Yemi to call me back, babe, because I'm getting too angry with you.
Yemi needs to...
Fuck off.
Well, OK. And he cut off the phone.
Since the council is not prepared to pay the deposit on a property he can't sustain by himself, Steve is back to square one.
Oh. I want to scream.
Having been evicted by the council from her temporary accommodation, Marilyn has come to the housing office to find out what help is available to her.
So, you've been evicted today. The bailiffs came this morning?
Yes, they did.
OK. So you turned down
uh-huh.
a permanent property?
Yeah, it wasn't suitable for me. Well, I didn't think it was suitable for me.
Right. And why was that?
Why was that? Because I get arthritis.
Mm-hmm.
There was no lift. I'm thinking, right. Wow.
So the premises had no lift?
No lift, and it was on the third floor.
And you turned down two other properties for being not suitable also?
Yeah, the first one is too small. I said, I'm not taking it, and plus dogs are not allowed.
So that was the first one.
The second one, I didn't even go and see it.
You've been offered properties for whatever reason that you've turned down. Now that you've turned it down, where can we go? Because you can't be in temporary accommodation indefinitely. The onus is now on yourselves, unfortunately, to find accommodation.
I think the situation, the circumstances are absolutely tragic. It is devastating for Marilyn and for her children to be put into this situation, and it is absolutely the last thing that the council would want to do or would have chosen to do. But ultimately, we were left with no choice.
With no prospect of help, Marilyn returns to stay with her mum.
Very disgusting. Well, what can you do? That's life, innit? Life goes on. You understand me? You know? It could have been worse.
Five 5,000 families are on the waiting list for a three-bedroom property. Jill's kids have flown the nest from her council house, but she's not prepared to downsize until she gets the two-bed house she's after.
I don't feel that I deserve anything fantastic or anything like that, don't get me wrong, but I think after all these years, I deserve something that I want.
The council is keen to get her property back.
If she move, it'll probably go and we have another family in it within a week.
Good afternoon, I'm from London Borough Tower Hamlets. We've come to interview today. Thank you very much.
I want to get out of here as much as they want to come in here.
Exactly.
And it just seems for 7.5 months I've been sitting here twiddling my thumbs and...
Now, we have some financial things here that my colleague will show you as well. May help you change your mind to give up the property. These are the incentives that we may be able to offer you.
Okay.
For a three-bedroom property like this, we offer you up to £1,000 as incentive to move out.
Okay.
So, as well as that, we make all the arrangement for you to move and find you a removal company. We have two that we use, so that will be done for you.
Honestly, what do you think my chances are of getting a house?
A ground floor house or ground floor property?
No, ground floor house.
Although you're going to have the priority, you know, you're going to have a 1A priority, which is the highest that we have. Those clients that have a medical priority, if they've had it longer than you, they will be considered first because the health advisor has stated ground floor only.
I'm not trying to be disrespectful or anything, but I'm telling you now, unless I get a house, I'm not moving.
You choose, and obviously we'll be able to assist you with what you've chosen. That's the way the system works.
Okay.
Okay?
Yep.
It's going to take her an extremely long time to get a house because they're few and in between.
You know, I think I deserve to be happy as well. I've lived in the borough all my life, so now I want something that I want. But whether I get it is another matter, but until I do, then I'm here.
Across the borough, Steve's wait for a council house has come to an end.
I just need to get out of here. What, you got it? Ooh. My notice to quit was on the 28th of February. You know, it's now the 31st of March. You know, I can't wait. I said, all right, so what you got for me? Nothing, was the answer. Nothing. So all we're going to do is sit up here waiting to be, like, waiting for the bailiffs to come around with a court order to kick me out. It's just been a complete waste of time.
Having failed to get a council house, Steve's been forced to move out of the borough to find an affordable place to live.
I'm 53, lived in this borough all my life, and look, it's like this. I've got to go to Loughton and rent privately. And as for the shortfall, there ain't no shortfall where I'm going to go now. The agent has had a word and have reduced the rent slightly. Of course I miss the park, of course I miss the canal, of course I... But I've had some happy times. So once I'm gone, I'm gone. Why? Brand new check this time. Hello, mister. Come in now. Goodbye, Devon G. You'll never get a place in Tehran, this.
If I could wave a magic wand, cure the housing need in this borough tomorrow, within a year there would be a demand for more accommodation because families grow. This council has built something like 4,000 affordable homes in the last 4 years, but it's really, really expensive. And trying to satisfy the housing needs of 20,000 households is impossible when that list is growing. And in the years to come, as prices rise and as demand increases, I think there will be a perfect storm.
Support, information for the issues raised in this programme can be found at the website channel4.com/support. Ricky Gervais' comedy Next on 4, writer, director and lead role. He goes by the name of Derek.
She lives alone in a three-bedroom maisonette.
This is my home. When I first moved in here, I had all my children with me, so it was a family home. I'm hoping to downsize, but at the moment, I'm getting nowhere fast.
On the private market, Jill's property would cost around £330 a week to rent. But the council charges just £127.
It's nice. It's a nice place, you know. I can't understand why they haven't pulled my arm off to get it for somebody. A big family. I'm just rumbling around here all on my own. This is another spare room. People could be living here. Stupid. Absolutely stupid.
The council wants her property to ease their long list of waiting families. So she's been placed at the top of the priority list. But they can't force Jill out, and she hasn't found anywhere to tempt her to move.
Town Hamlets has quite a few applicants that are living in properties that are larger than what they require. Single people living in 3- and 4-bedroom accommodation. But there's no policy to say that if you're in larger accommodation, you must give up the property.
I just think I really deserve, I mean, that's the wrong word to use, but I would really prefer to have a house than anything else, or just something with a garden. If you want to live in a tower block, there's plenty of them, but it's just nothing suitable. And I feel that if I can't get what I want, then I'm not moving. Simple as that.
The council is having to rent expensive private properties until permanent council houses can be found for its 2,000 homeless households. Having refused 3 permanent offers, Marilyn is now about to be evicted from her temporary accommodation. But desperate not to lose her home, she's preparing for a siege.
Get up early in the morning before they come and get me. I bought me chicken. A whole chicken that would last me at least 2 days. That would do. I will survive. I got me Swiss roll. I got everything. Me crackers. I like me crackers with me cheese. When they come, I'm not going to open my door. I'm staying put, so I need food for me to eat. Simple.
If we have a situation where people are just refusing to move out of temporary accommodation, we have to use our powers and get them moving so we can free up the properties for those people who are coming behind them.
At 10 a.m, the bailiffs arrived to start the eviction.
I've got butterflies now. What can I say?
Is the bailiff on the call here? If you open the door, we can obviously speak to you and tell you and advise you what you can do.
Merlin, they will force entry. You don't want them to force entry, do you?
And you've got the amount of time it takes for the police to get here.
My kids aren't supposed to go through that. Do you understand me? Not at all. And that's not fair.
Once the police are here, we're going to come in. If you don't open the door, we're going to force entry.
Look what he's got. He's got his crowbar.
Listen to me. The police are here.
So what are you trying to say? So when you come in, then what happens to us?
Marilyn, it's the police. Can you let me in to discuss this, please?
I haven't done anything, I haven't done no crime. If I come out of this house, I'm on the street.
Either way, you let me in and we have a quick discussion, or we'll just force entry, so it's up to you.
After an hour, the door is forced open.
Yeah, come on. Thank you. Yeah. That's the police, yeah?
But they've been very spiteful for me. No understanding. Don't lie for you, lot. You've got a roof on your head, innit? I'm packing some clothes for my son. I'm packing some clothes for myself. And my daughter's packing her clothes. Are you ready, honey bunch? All right then, come on. It's unfair because they should have given me something long time ago, 4 years ago, back in 10 years ago. Classes as criminal, I'm not a criminal.
People sadly have to understand that we can only do so much. We can't have a situation where we're effectively bed blocking temporary accommodation. I've got families sitting in bed and breakfast hotels for far longer than they should do because I don't have enough temporary accommodation to move people into.
The council is faced with such a shortage of available properties that a quarter of those in temporary accommodation have to be housed outside the borough.
You're going to Swanscombe, Dartford. The nearest affordable one we have for yourself is Kent.
Kent.
Yeah, Kent.
All my support, like midwife and everything, they're all here.
Yeah, I mean, this is only temporary. You moved out there until you can get yourself a permanent accommodation, so you can get that back in the borough.
If it's just temporary, I don't really want to transfer anything.
Yeah, but I mean, it's temporary as in at least maybe 1, 2, 3 years. It's a big adjustment. You're moving out of the area you've been in, but us, the cheapest accommodation, unfortunately, is moving further and further out.
New parents, Sharif and Laura, have only just joined the waiting list for a council house. Because they have a baby, they were given emergency accommodation and placed in a bed and breakfast room.
Well, I got a phone call yesterday about 5 o'clock, 5:30. I had a phone call from housing lady telling me that she's got a temporary flat for us in Enfield. And then when I heard temporary flat, I was overexcited. I didn't hear it. What else? She said so much other stuff to me, but I didn't pay attention. I just heard, yeah, we have your flat, come 9:30 in the morning for your keys.
It's took forever to get here. Definitely, it took forever. But good things come to those who wait.
Sheriff, to booth one, please.
While they wait for a council house, they've been allocated temporary accommodation, but it's in a different borough.
We've got your property. This is the address where it is. Here.
Yeah.
Is it one or two bed?
It's a one bedroom.
Do you know if it's on the ground floor?
I'm not too sure.
Okay. This is a surprise then.
Our first home together. Gonna be excited. I don't know where we are anymore.
Yeah, it's like walking into the unknown, really. Well, it says it's half an hour on the train, so it is quite scary. So, especially with a child.
If sold, this one-bedroom ground-floor flat would cost.
You know, has she got a place to play and just have fun? She can't do that. She can't grow and learn, and it's just not fair.
We've got a three-month-old baby, and like a baby, they're supposed to be brought up in a stable home, comfortable. So that, I feel that gives us a bit of a priority.
By law, the council can only house families in bed and breakfasts for up to 6 weeks.
Families will spend a short period in bed and breakfast, and then their journey will be to self-contained temporary accommodation, typically a council property, now owned by a private landlord, and is now renting back to us what was social housing stock originally. We are paying an awful lot more rent than the original rent for that property. That's a fact of life.
In Tower Hamlets, it costs £31 million a year to house families in temporary accommodation. With such a long waiting list for a permanent place, families can be housed like this for years and often become attached to their homes. Marilyn and her two children have been in temporary accommodation for 10 years.
Lily, you're following me.
Having fled their original home due to domestic violence.
Well, I used to live in a house. It was brand new. I lived there for 8 years, but I had to move out because of domestic violence and the social services. I have to go for my safety. But I didn't really want to leave this house because I love the house. It says, don't worry, you will get another place. You'll get another house. So I thought, okay, let me take that chance. So I took that chance.
It costs £323 a week to house the family in this two-bedroom flat. But the council has now told them they must leave.
No, tomorrow I'm going to be evicted. I haven't got nowhere to go yet. And they're supposed to come at 8 o'clock in the morning. Yeah? I'm not going nowhere. I'm staying put. Because I haven't got a roof on my head. I've got all my furniture in the flat. And I haven't got nowhere to go.
After 9 years of unsuccessfully bidding for a permanent property, the housing office offered Marilyn three different council homes, but she turned them all down.
But you can't just turn around and give me what I never bid for. That's not fair. I went to look at it, and then the man in the builder that was decorating the place there, because it's a nice place, isn't it? I goes, is it? I said, not for me, mate. And I looked around, I said, no, thank you. And I walked away.
The council has decided it can no longer justify the expense of keeping Marilyn in temporary accommodation.
We've got into this very unfortunate situation because Marilyn has been bidding for many, many years for properties that she will not get. I think the problem is that she didn't understand the difference between exercising choice and choosing what she wanted and what she was actually going to be able to get. Because I think I'm assuming she just thought that she could get what we couldn't give her.
I don't want too much, but at least you could have given me something better than that. You give the people what they want. The reason why they give me this place there, because nobody wants it.
For the last decade, the council has been storing Marilyn's furniture free of charge. But 2 months ago, her possessions were returned to her.
This is my sitting room, which I've got all my furniture here because it was in storage for 10 years and I cannot move. And that's the way I'm living. And it's a nightmare. You can come in here now. This is my bedroom. That's where me and my daughter sleeps. And it's just crowded. Not even a cat can swing in there. So I'm living like a pilcher.
Marilyn has had 6 weeks' notice of her eviction, but now has just 24 hours to vacate the property.
People that are born in this country, they can't get a place. And people come over here, they're the ones that's getting the first priority to get a place. The system is not fair.
Steve is hoping for a council flat, but time is not on his side. He's facing eviction from his privately rented home in just 2 weeks.
I want a tenancy. I want a place that I can call my home. Ground floor, senior type, fixed term. I would love to have that place. Total weekly cost, £171.27. That's £80 cheaper than here. Now that is a result. Right, I'm gonna go apply now, right? There are. At present, there are 234 people in front of me.
Because there's such a shortage of social housing, the council is encouraging people further down the waiting list to move into private accommodation.
So I'm gonna call all these offices and see how I get on.
They've offered to help pay the deposit if Steve can secure a privately rented flat for no more than his £245 a week housing benefit.
Hello, how can I help?
Yeah, I was just wondering if you've got any one bedroom or studio apartments to let on the ground floor.
We've got one bed on at £300 per week, just off Hackney Road.
Right, well, my budget will be £250 a week. You say it's ground floor, yeah?
Yeah, it's ground floor.
Do you accept the housing benefit with good references?
Unfortunately, we just don't really.
Do you take housing benefit?
I don't believe we do down here, no.
Thank you.
About that.
That's fine, darling, thank you. I don't want private housing. I'm in a little bit of pain. I was a recovering alcoholic. I must be insane to start drinking because of what it does to me. It's making things 20 times worse.
What might do it?
The stress. 245 quid a week.
I don't have any one bed for £245 a week.
That one's a no. I've got references from my previous landlord. Please, my friend, if you can find me something, you would really make my day.
345 they want for a
345 for a one bedroom.
If he doesn't find somewhere to live in the next fortnight, Steve could be made homeless.
I ain't really getting nowhere very fast.
In Tower Hamlets, there are 20,000 households waiting for a council property. But each week, only 30 homes become available, with larger family houses the most rare. Retired bus driver Jill has been in her council house for 20 years, just around £150,000.
I think it's this one.
What's that?
It's our sweet new home. It's really nice.
I like it.
I like this a lot.
Cupboards.
Everything's here. I'm so excited. I mean, I'm already imagining where the sterilizer's gonna go and...
What, a shower?
Electric.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Let's have a look at the bedroom.
The boudoir.
You can put the bed here, cot here.
Oh, I like the sofa.
In B&B, we just had one room and a little sink and a fridge. Here, we've got everything.
How much does this place cost a week? You guys
to be here? I don't have
a clue. Yeah, don't know.
$320 a week.
Ooh.
We're definitely blessed to have a ground floor like this. Definitely. And we deserve it. We really deserve this. Because we waited bloody well long enough.
That's our home for the next few years, hopefully.
I'm thinking forever, like the way I'm planning everything.
Steve is also having to look at properties outside Tower Hamlets. With little chance of getting a council house before he's evicted from his private flat, he's come to view a property that will accept tenants on housing benefit.
Well, I must be honest, it's on the ground floor. A bit small, but what can I expect? Just let me check the kitchen out. Don't like the ob, mind you. And the oven's a Zanussi instead of a Bosch. Thank God it hasn't got 40 steps to get there.
The council has agreed to pay his deposit if they're satisfied he can afford the rent.
Yeah, the bedroom's very adequate. It's a lovely place and I'd love to have it.
Although this ground floor flat is cheaper than it would be in Tower Hamlets, it's still £50 a week more than Steve's housing benefit, which goes against council policy.
The market value for rental and what they as a benefit pay is means I don't actually, there ain't nothing I can find within that cap. It's as simple as that.
Steve's fate is now in the council's hands.
In a lot of pain, darling, to be honest. A really bad pain.
I have spoken to my manager.
Yes, he has a problem with the shortfall.
My family and friends are ready to rally up for me the £50 shortfall or just slightly less. I've lived in this borough for 53 years, sweetheart, and I found a property that's very adequate.
When we put somebody in a tenancy, the whole point of us paying out the money is so that they can get into a property where they can sustain it.
Well, I can sustain it, so what's the problem?
But then we have to be sure that you can do that.
Well, I'm telling you I can.
Concerns around that.
So where am I meant to live? I can't deal with this anxiety. I can't deal with it. The stress is driving me... Sorry, I nearly swore, but please. Have you got any plans for me or any suggestion?
What you need to do is look for a different property. This property is unaffordable. You can't afford them.
I feel like throwing a fucking phone. What you're saying is now then it's a no, is that what you're saying? Have you got a suitable property lined up for me then? You know, where's a suitable property?
I do not have a suitable property.
I can only deal with a ground floor. Have I got to let the landlord take me to court? And then have the bailiff train slinging me on the streets? Next I'll be homeless. What is wrong with your manager?
If you find a property
within local housing allowance, we are willing to pay £664.30, which is the local housing allowance for one bedroom in Epping Forest.
Darling, get in the real world. Go out there and try to find a place to live in Tower Hamlets. Go anywhere in London. I'm sorry I'm shouting, but I ain't going nowhere. I ain't going forward nowhere, and it's making me really ill.
Before we continue with anything else...
Just get Yemi to call me back, babe, because I'm getting too angry with you. Fuck off.
Well, okay. And he cut off the phone.
Since the council is not prepared to pay the deposit on a property he can't sustain by himself, Steve is back to square one.
I want to scream.
Having been evicted by the council from her temporary accommodation, Marilyn has come to the housing office to find out what help is available to her.
So, you've been evicted today. The bailiffs came this morning?
Yes, they did.
OK, so you turned down
uh-huh.
a permanent property?
Yeah, it wasn't suitable for me. Well, I didn't think it was suitable for me.
Right. And why was that?
Why was that? Because I get arthritis. There was no lift. I'm thinking, why?
So the premises had no lift?
No lift, and it was on the third floor.
And you turned down two other properties for being not suitable also?
Yeah, the first one is too small. I says, I'm not taking it, and plus, dogs are not allowed.
So that was the first one.
The second one, I didn't even go and see it.
You've been offered properties for whatever reason that you've turned down. Now that you've turned it down, where can we go? Because you can't be in temporary accommodation indefinitely. The onus is now on yourselves, unfortunately, to find accommodation.
I think the situation, the circumstances are absolutely tragic. It is devastating for Marilyn and for her children to be put into this situation, and it is absolutely the last thing that the council would want to do or would have chosen to do. But ultimately, we were left with no choice.
With no prospect of help, Marilyn returns to stay with her mum.
Very disgusting. Well, what can you do? That's life, innit? Life goes on. You understand me? You know? It could have been worse.
...5,000 families are on the waiting list for a three-bedroom property. Jill's kids have flown the nest from her council house, but she's not prepared to downsize until she gets the two-bed house she's after.
I don't feel that I deserve anything fantastic or anything like that, don't get me wrong, but I think after all these years, I deserve something that I want.
The council is keen to get her property back.
If she move, it'll probably go and we have another family in it within a week.
Good afternoon, and we're from London Borough Town Hamlets. We've come to interview today.
Yeah.
Thank you very much.
I want to get out of here as much as they want to come in here.
Exactly.
And it just seems for 7.5 months I've been sitting here twiddling my thumbs and...
Now, we have some financial things here that my colleague will show you as well. May help you change your mind to give up the property.
5 million homes in Britain are provided at reduced rent through social housing.
We get over 1,200 clients bidding for the one property.
But with 4.5 million people in the queue, there's a long wait.
I've been on a Tower Hamlets waiting list somewhere near 10 years now.
Now it's 9 years now, still waiting.
Probably about 300 or 400 bids for it.
Keep bidding as you're doing.
When a vacancy does come up, competition is fierce.
It's not as if I'm being choosy. I can't even get a look in.
Is the bailiff here?
I'm going to be evicted.
Would you be keen on taking this property?
I'd be happy to live here.
It's down to local councils to decide who deserves a home the most.
We don't have a vast amount of properties come available. That's the difference between us and the estate agents.
We've got a conflict of interest here. We can't help you.
As each household stakes a claim for the keys to a council house.
We've got a three-month-old baby. I feel that gives us a bit of a priority.
I would love to have that place.
I would really prefer just something with a garden.
The London Borough of Tower Hamlets is at capacity. The council is dealing with the fastest growing population in the United Kingdom. It's also one of the country's poorest areas. There's a queue of over 20,000 households trying to get a council house.
Why there are no council flat, right, for us? And I would like to know what is the next step.
We will never be able to match demand with supply.
Yeah, but like, she's heavily pregnant as well.
It's a struggle that requires more and more resources, more and more innovation, more and more energy. How long we can continue to do that, I don't know.
With just 30 properties a week becoming available, a bottleneck has formed. Some of the few properties soon to become available include this one-bedroom flat. A rarity as it's situated on the ground floor. And this fourth floor flat, currently undergoing a full refurbishment. But who deserves the keys the most?
Steven, put 17, please. Interview room number 17, please. Good morning to you.
Who are you, sir?
How are you?
In a lot of pain.
Oh, good, good. What's your date of birth, please?
19th for the 10th, 78, and now 60. I've got to keep me human, mate, you know what I mean?
For 53-year-old Steve, Tower Hamlets has been his manor his whole life.
I mean, all my family was born in the East End, even not just my grandparents, like my grandparents' brothers and sisters, you know, so, and anyone with their surname is family.
Steve is hoping for a ground floor council property. He currently lives in a one-bed apartment, but as he suffers from arthritis, the 40 stairs have become unbearable.
My life has changed so dramatically, and my prospects are just none. My current condition means I'm unemployable. And on a bad day, I don't like to say this, but on a bad day, I cry. It makes me depressed. And it really gets me upset. And I feel like I'm in a fucking jail cell. You know, I feel like I'm in prison, in a luxury prison, if you like.
To make matters worse, the landlord of his private rented flat wants his property back.
Unfortunately, I'm just had a notice to quit. So I've got to be out by February the 28th, which has, you know, really set my life into chaos. I'll have bailiffs coming round, and they'll have the right to probably kick the door in or enter the property and just clear out my stuff. You know what I mean? You just feel hopeless. No hope. Worst feeling in the world.
With his eviction looming, Steve has just 6 weeks to find a new home.
So basically, you want a proper council tenancy.
I would like a tenancy.
Yes. Yeah. We have to be realistic here. Yeah. There are lots of people on the waiting list, and the chances are very small.
Have they all lived in this borough all their life?
I should think so, yeah. I should think so.
With so many people on the waiting list, Steve needs to convince the council his housing application is more urgent than others.
Are you disabled?
Well, I've got arthritis.
Arthritis.
I'm in constant pain. I just cannot deal with stairs. I'm also a recovering alcoholic. You know, I mean, I've relapsed a few times, but at the moment, I'm doing my best to not drink. And I've got no asbo, so I'm not a danger to none of my neighbours. All my neighbours love me.
That's very good, yeah.
Even the ones that can't speak English.
So, if you want a council property, you have to continue to bid. So, I cannot say to you that you will not get a council flat. No. However, my job here is to advise you to consider other options. We may be able to help you get you accommodation in private sector.
It's possible that you will get a council accommodation, but the likelihood that very soon that's going to happen, that cannot be guaranteed.
I'd rather it be a tenancy, something in my name, and a tenant of the council. The private sector, you've got no security, you don't know where you stand. I've been a resident in this borough all my life. Yes, I think I should get priority.
Getting your hands on a council house isn't easy with such a shortage of housing stock. So the council have devised a bidding process where applicants can stake a claim on newly available properties.
Tower Hamlets operates a choice-based letting system, and this allows applicants to note their interest in the type of accommodation that we have available each week. It's down to the client to choose if they wish to be considered for that particular property by placing a bid.
It's a two-bedroom, a nice size.
Third floor, one lift, which is good.
Yeah, that would be a nice property to bid on.
When the applicant places a bid, the computer works out their bid position based on how long they've been waiting and their level of need or priority.
There is quite a few people in front of me, which is about 160 people at the moment.
Well, this is 255 above me.
It's just like a waiting game, really.
Bidding closes every Friday, and the system analyses which applicants are at the top of the list for each property. But even then, the ordeal isn't over. This one-bedroom council flat in Tower Hamlets has just become available. The property's been fully refurbished. Privately, it would fetch in the region of £265 a week. But the council are offering it at a more affordable £104 a week.
We've got a viewing of a one-bedroom flat on the fourth floor. There's three applicants that's going to be viewing the property.
Local resident Dean is currently unemployed and has come to the viewing with his father.
I'm here because I've been on Tower Hamlets waiting list, and I've been on it roughly, I don't know, somewhere near 10 years now. And this is actually my first viewing for a flat in the 10 years that I've been on.
It's lovely, one bedroom. They're on a general waiting list applicants, all three of them. And they're all single. They all bid for this place.
Live with parents at the moment, so and I feel like I've got to that age where I just need to sort of get out independence, you know.
How old are you?
I'm 30, 31 in May. I feel I'm way over the limit to actually be still living with my parents.
Applicant number one, they're first on the list for refusal. If for any reason they refuse, the offer is made to applicant number two. And if they accept, great. If they don't, then it goes to applicant number three.
I'm actually third on the list. As far as I know, there's up to about six of us going to be viewing, and I'm the third choice, third person. If the other two obviously turn it down, then it's down to me. I was hoping I'd be probably the only one here. Yep, no way. Yeah.
This one-bedroom council flat has just become available. Local resident Dean has been on the council's waiting list for 10 years, and this is his first viewing.
Maybe I deserve a place for living here so long, but there's people out there that have worse problems than what I do.
Applicant number one, have a look at the property first, and then number two, and then we'll call you in.
But as he's applicant number three, Dean will only be offered the property if the two people in front of him turn it down.
What can you do? Private renting is going through the roof. There's not really much you can do. If you've got to wait, you've got to wait. We're British, aren't we? We're used to standing queues.
A brand new kitchen and brand new bathroom. So what do you think? Do you like it?
Yeah.
Not sure.
It's a nice area.
Yeah, it's a good size. It's a double bed. So do you want to think about it?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll let applicant number two in then. Applicant number two. Okay, so everything's been replaced.
Yeah, I could see myself living here. But I say it's a nice area. There's nothing wrong with it. The walls ain't falling down around me or nothing.
Do you like it? Okay. We're just going to let applicant number three in now. Mr. Dean Febb, do you want to come in? Come in. New bathroom and kitchen. Just over a year and a half ago. Right, this was the living room. We've got a private balcony at the back. This was the bedroom. What do you think?
Yeah, I'd say it's decent size. Better than what I'm in the room I'm in at the moment.
If, for example, applicant number one and two refuses a property, would you be keen on taking this property?
Yeah, I don't see why not. I'd be happy to live here.
Okay, we're just gonna go out and see if number one have made a decision. We're done, sorry. Okay, applicant number one, have you decided? You're gonna accept the property? Okay. Sorry guys, applicant number one accepted the property. Yeah? Two and three, sorry. You'll be number one, hopefully, soon. Now you're on the top of the list, so you're just gonna have to carry on bidding.
I am a little bit disappointed, but like I say, because I was free, it's just one of them things. Hopefully next time I'll be closer to the top. Hopefully it won't take me another 10 years to actually get into another place.
Dean's wait to fly the family nest isn't over yet. As families expand, the council is left to deal with an increasing problem.
Families are given accommodation that meets the needs at the time of the allocation. And we have never, ever been in the comfortable position where we've been able to allocate accommodation that anticipates that families will grow. And of course, families will grow.
When Rahula and her husband moved into this two-bedroom maisonette, they only had one child.
When I got married, I always wanted a little bit bigger family.
Now the couple have six daughters and are desperate for a larger home.
Now it's 9 years now. Still waiting.
I sleep on the bottom of the bunk with my younger sister. At the top, my second older sister sits there. My older sister, who's 19, she sleeps on the single bed. In the other room, my mum sleeps with my baby sister and my younger sister. The whole house is getting damp, really, in the corners. I think it's because we've been living here for such a long time.
It's really difficult, especially for this country, to suffer my children like that.
3-bedroom or 2-bedroom property, you could get over 1,200 clients bidding for the one property. We just can't help everybody. It's unfortunate. It's not a quick fix here.
The strain of these overcrowded conditions often becomes too much to bear, and family members are forced to leave. With a limited supply of council property available, the housing office is having to go to extreme lengths to house those most in need.
Families will present to us, often in an emergency situation, and we respond in that emergency by providing bed and breakfast accommodation.
So, just changing the baby.
Unemployed 26-year-old Sharif and his young family have been given one room after being evicted from his family home.
You can see that it's not really spacious enough for a family of three. So it is a bit difficult, but we get on, we push through. And my mum lives in a two-bedroom house, and there was me, my mum, two of my sisters and my partner. So it was really, really overcrowded. So we had to, when baby arrived, we stayed there for a few weeks, but there wasn't enough space. So we had to move out. My mum said that we had to leave. It's difficult. It's stressing me out a little, because I have to hold myself together for my baby and for my partner.
It's not fair. If it was just a pair of us, it would be fine. We could cope with it. But she's the one who's, you know, little and she doesn't realise. So.
What would you like for the future?
A home. Somewhere, you know, somewhere safe and stable. Somewhere she could wake up and think, you know, am I going to get a phone call today and are we going to have to move?